This is President Jackson, whose tombstone says, "I killed the bank." Jackson had about six or seven attempts on his life, likely by the bankers at the time. When our country was first formed, the first bank of the United States, the first central bank, was our bank. And then we had the Revolutionary War, the War of 1812, which was settled with Britain in 1814. And one of the features of the settlement was that Britain got to install the second bank of the United States, which was a Rothschild-controlled British bank. Well, Andrew Jackson objected to this bank, and so Andrew Jackson, throughout his political career, sought to close down the Rothschild-controlled central bank. And in the mid-1830s, Andrew Jackson was successful in closing down the Rothschild Bank, and therefore he put on his tombstone, "I killed the bank." Well, it's possible that they killed him. And I think that the money makers, the money masters, put their trophy kills on our money. I think that that's flaunting who they've killed. Think about the other presidents that have been killed, like Abraham Lincoln, who at the end of the Civil War introduced greenbacks. That was a currency that was introduced into circulation at no cost, no interest to we the people. It was $5.3 million designed to stimulate the economy towards the end of the Civil War. And Abraham Lincoln, bang. This is November 22nd, which is the anniversary of the assassination of John F. Kennedy. And in, I think it was June of 1963, Kennedy issued Executive Order 11110, which authorized the U.S. Treasury to print paper money. Those were United States notes, $2 and $5 bills. It was $4.3 billion in $2 and $5 bills that went into circulation at no interest. Now, every time you get a Federal Reserve note from these guys in this building over here, we're paying interest on that. For example, when they did the bailout and created $700 billion, which has turned into $2.3 trillion, the families that own the Federal Reserve member banks get interest on that money, and they don't pay taxes on that interest. Well, JFK's Executive Order 11110 had the Treasury, the U.S. Treasury, take over the role of the Federal Reserve to introduce currency into circulation at no interest. Why should there be interest on money that we the people use to exchange? Who should have a concession to sell money to us? That doesn't make sense. And that gift of the Federal Reserve's concession to sell us our own money was given during a recess session of Congress in the winter of 1913, while many congressmen were back in their own districts. And a majority of those that remained behind were traitors and gave away our system of money to a private group of Rothschild-controlled bankers. Many of the Federal Reserve owners are not even American citizens, they're European. Anyway, we're here on November 22nd to celebrate President Kennedy's courage to go against the Federal Reserve and declare that we the people should be able to print our own money. This place needs to go down, folks.
I'm here today because I don't believe in what is going on today is correct. The Federal Reserve is an unconstitutional idea. The fact that they can give out $500 billion to foreign banks and get in front of Congress and say, "We do not have to tell you," is repugnant. And it's un-American, and it's time we change it and ask for better standards.
Now, what do you think about the passage of Ron Paar's H.R. 1207? Do you think anything will come of it?
I think, if anything, it's going to be great for public awareness. I think we'll see a lot of problems in the Senate. I think it'll bog down at the Senate level. But it's great for public awareness, and people are starting to get the message. And I think people are starting to see that dishonest government is not the best for America.
Hey, we're down here today at the Of the Fed rally. This is a very, very important gathering down here today. As you can see, standing behind me is the Federal Reserve Building here in Kansas City. This is the Audit the Fed rally. one of many that's going on around the country today. I think this is a very important gathering that we're here for the passage of Ron Paul's Audit the Fed Bill 1207. Very, very important. There's a lot of people out here that, that solely believe in this is what we need to do. You see protesters driving by honking in support. This is something that really needs to be audited. It's way past due. The last person that tried to audit this that was a really big deal in our U.S. history was John Kennedy. John Kennedy wanted to abolish the Federal Reserve, and you see what happened to him. The U.S. government assassinated him. You know, people blamed it on many things for years. It is what it is. It was just simply a killing because he wanted to abolish the Federal Reserve. So we're out here today supporting this cause. I think more people need to get involved in it. They need to do the research. Go to endthefed.com. There's just all kinds of websites that really, really talk in support of what we're doing out here today. There's Oath Keepers out here today. There's all kinds of other people out here speaking today. This is sponsored by the Liberty Restoration Project, which I am proudly part of. I would stay tuned to that website, libertyrestorationproject.org, I believe it is, and find out when these events are coming up next, because it's very well organized organization and good thing to be a part of.
These countries are in serious trouble.
Look, they still have high-end stuff.
Political system in D.C. that just plain doesn't listen to what it is the people are saying. You go back to the Bush administration and the first bailout, these people damn near melted the congressional switchboard 1,000-1 for 17 minutes that day. It was shut down because of the overloaded volume of calls. 1,000-1 against the bailout. They did it anyway. So you gotta ask, who is Washington actually representing? Us or the corporations? Have a good day.
So this is the Federal Reserve, folks. Those pieces of paper that we carry around in our pockets are just a promissory note, as it says on the piece of paper. And in God we trust. Well, that's just to make sure that all the people that are religious think that we're doing something very nice to be carrying around something that says in God we trust. Well, they are trusting in our gullibility that this means something, that this money has some sort of value. Actually, they're looting us all. The $700 billion that was passed last October, a year ago, has turned into over $2 trillion. There was no ceiling on that spending to do the bailouts. And the people that get the bailout money, we don't even know who they are. General Motors asked for $25 billion from the Fed to try to bail out their retirees. One of my friends worked for General Motors for 30 years, lost $250,000, his entire retirement savings in his General Motors bankruptcy. And the $25 billion compares to $700 billion that the Congress gave away to the Fed with no auditing requirements. We don't even know who got the money. We don't know what they've done with it. It's a crime, folks. We're being looted. Our money is going to heck. Look at the gold price as it climbs. Pretty soon, we'll go the way of the Weimar Republic. A coup has taken place in America. Many people don't realize it, but we, the people, no longer have representation in our Congress. The Congress has sold us out, or they've been extorted to perform some actions and pass legislation in the middle of the night. And we've run out of time, folks. This is an emergency. America is under siege and a coup has occurred. It's time to abandon your normal routines. Don't take so much time off and enjoy things, but get involved. Learn about what's happened to this country. Learn about 9/11, for example, which is a big lie. Learn about the Oklahoma City bombing, which was an insider job involving the FBI and the alcohol, tobacco, and firearms. There were bombs inside the building. There's the Two Blast Club in Oklahoma City. That's a baby step to understanding 9/11, which is perhaps the biggest ruse perpetrated on humanity in human history. Anyway, it's time, folks. It's time. The revolution is near. If we don't get their attention through our polite petitioning, the revolution is upon us, and we better be ready.